Brett, who is your garbage person of the week?
My garbage person of the week is Markwayne Mullin, Senator from Oklahoma, who thinks, you know, there's a better chance now that embattled defense secretary nominee Pete Hegseth will be confirmed by the Senate thanks to his mommy. Take a look.
It's more likely or less likely that he gets confirmed than it was 24 or 48 hours ago.
Oh, I think it's more likely now. I don't know if you got the opportunity to watch his mother on Fox today, this morning, but she did just a phenomenal job, put a lot of those questions to rest. And he's up here working hard. And the more he meets with people, as I said, the more positive response we get. So every day he's doing what he needs to do, we're getting closer to the ability to get him confirmed. But like I said, it's a tough road for him, but it is a 100% doable.
Of all the things that right-wing politicians tell you to be skeptical about, experts who show up and be like, yo, here's just some data. And they're like, ignore it. I focus on the very important, real stuff out there that should be taken seriously. This guy thinks that we should, it's more likely we should confirm a purportedly drunken Secretary of Defense because the expert known as his mom thinks it's a good idea. Some background on this story. There were leaks that his mom wrote an email. Pete Hegseth, who's the former Fox News host and former member of the military who has now been nominated for Secretary of Defense. The story was that his mom came out and or emailed him that he should be ashamed of himself essentially for being an abuser of women and treating women so horribly. And after that leaked, people were like, his mom thinks he's an abuser of women. He probably shouldn't be the defense secretary. And now she's doing a media tour on Fox News, basically asking a bunch of people, this is my son, he's a good boy. Because of course she would. In my read on this subject, she's being a good mom. She doesn't want to ruin her son's life and she doesn't want her son to ruin people's lives. So when the Secretary of Defense job was not on the line, when it was just a mom telling her son that he shouldn't be a bastard, she wrote an email to him saying he shouldn't be a bastard because that's what good moms do. But as soon as she realizes that her actions might take away her son's dream job, she's going on Fox News saying, don't take away his dream job, because of course she would do that. But in one of those scenarios, the job wasn't on the line, so she's able to be just honest. And in the other scenario, the job is on the line, so she's clearly lying to protect her son, just like any decent mother would do.
Yeah.
In any scenario. Yet Markwayne Mullin is like, I think my constituents are so stupid, they think we should put a war hawk, seemingly alcoholic guy in charge of the Department of Defense because his mommy said so. It's so stupid.
Well, okay. He would stop being an alcoholic.
That's amazing.
He swears if you give him the job.
Yeah.
Uh-huh. If you don't, I assume he'll double down, I guess.
I will defend anyone's right to have a shot before they do a shoot, period. It relaxes you, or before going to the dentist for that matter. I do both sometimes.
That makes sense, I think. Anyway, yeah, I tweeted something to the effect of he gives his vow that he'll stop drinking if he gets the job as if he's the guy who takes vows seriously. Like, no, here's what I don't understand about this fundamentally. What's that?
It's the most like, no, I promise I'll stop.
I can stop anytime I want. Has he promised to stop with the affairs? What I don't understand about this is, okay, like, you have this mountain of reasons to not put him in the position. What is the on the other end of like the pivot point? Why is it worth dealing with all of that and accepting all of that? It's not like, yeah, you know, there's the cheating and the drinking and the warmongering and the chanting kill all Muslims that most that people thing. Don't even mention when talking about this, which seems strange to me. I feel like that should be enough to disqualify you. And the warmongering against Iran and the weird Christian national stuff. But nobody can deny that he's super qualified for the position. Who actually believes that? Nobody believes that. some of his Fox coworkers are like, yeah, it'd be cool if one of us was in charge. That's it. And I guess he's a loyalist. So I don't know if like maybe Trump knows so much about this guy that he'd do whatever he wants because he's the most blackmailable person in the media. Or maybe Pete Hegseth knows as much about Trump that he can get the job because Trump is one of the most blackmailable politicians. I don't know. Maybe it's a mutually assured blackmail situation.
No, I think he's like Pete Hegseth likes me. He looks like a soldier and that's it. And he's central casting. Yeah. That's it. Yeah. Period.
We are learning though. If you want to be an alpha male, which obviously Brett and I do, don't take a bubble bath. Do have mommy call up all the people who might stop you from getting a job.
So crazy.
Obviously.